the way in which the case of the organization of ecosystem is being studied, because the end also the after formulation is problematic, and so what people did was to actually start engaging that with the corresponding equation.
Where do these auxiliary fields appear? But of course, they appear in all covariant derivatives. So, for instance, if we have Particular, in zero, and one and more.
And then there's a correction, a deformation. Again, this is just a underway of rising the momentum, the derivative of the momentum, so the translation along this vector. So this is what we will have on the space. We have a correction. But this, again, this Q is a matrix in a space, which looks like a polar. So it depends on the central charges, depends on the up charges, depends on the background that this field case will take. And as I said, in general, it is linear, you have three-day fields, so the formation is linear. And you also have it. You take two spin-offs to the same up charge, you get zero, and the same thing for the field as well. Okay? So, at this point, we could start studying the more general solution to the equation. I don't want to do that, we can go. So right here, so that's the area of yesterday. I just want to point out some key solutions that will be important for us later. So here, we're going to keep it. We want to discuss solutions, so let's take a compact of the ball. Let's take some compact orientable and most Riemann surface sigma, some genus. So we're not putting any boundary here. So what solution can we find? The first solution, that we can find on any metal, any sigma, any metric. It's very simple, so we turn on the background for the gauge field that comes for the affinity, we got a half of the spin connection. And then the spinos, which are chiral, and constant. And then we take these other things. Sorry. Yeah, so you can use any metric you want, but you want anything connection you want. And I'm saying if you plug in this in the equation, you will get a solution to these equations. Yeah, but this will be the topological property. This is the topological property. It doesn't mean that the is topological, it's just saying that you have to think any metric. But it turns out that this is the topological field. There's nothing here if you do this GRC procedure that we described, and we thought about, again, about that example, the field will become topological. Now, why this is a solution? Maybe this is very easy to see. So, first of all, the guys are zero, so it doesn't matter. You only have the covariant derivative. And you have this background for the unsymmetry. And now, well, we are in two dimensions, so the same connection is in SO2, this is U1. And so, in fact, the same connection is just an abelian gauge field. And so, for instance, well, let's say this guy is a negative chirality, so it's negative charge on the spin connection, but it has positive up charge, and so the two things cancel, and so we turn on the background for the affinity that precisely cancels the spin connection. And so what happens is that the covariant derivative of epsilon minus is just equal to the standard derivative of epsilon minus because of this cancellation, in fact, it's a constant. The same thing for the other guy, it's a positive chirality, but negative up charge, again, the two cancel out, and it's a constant. Alright, so this is a very simple solution, it's been on for a long time, and it's called AP. In this solution, there are two preserved super charges, we started with 4, we have 2.2, we can preserve 2, for half of it with the opposite of charges, and the algebra that we obtain looks like the following. So the anchor commutator, if we specialize the commutator that before is 0, and it has to do so because here, it's 0, because remember here, there was the lead derivative along this Schilling vector here. Physical states that are closed, then the theory is topological. Here is exactly the same thing. Okay, today, so this solution was been known for a long time, it was a sample. And in fact, that, for genus G, G greater than 1 is all we have. However, if you take lower genus, there are other solutions. In particular, I would like to look at the case of the sphere. Again, there are extra solutions for any metric, so let me consider the round metric. And of course, the topological space exists also on the sphere. However, well, because of this condition here, you see that when you do the topological space, you have some units of magnetic flux for the asymmetry. In the sense that if you integrate, you ask, okay, let's take the asymmetry flux, what is the field strength, the magnetic flux for the asymmetry. Let's compute the number of units of magnetic flux. This is equal to the spin connection. For the derivative of the spin connection, this is the scalar curvature, and just for that, you get G minus 1. So here there are some number of units of asymmetry flux. And this solution exists on the sphere as well. However, it turns out that on the sphere we have another solution. Which, if you like, is no solution. In which we don't turn on any asymmetry flux. And here again, we are on the round of two. It is an untwisted solution, an untwisted asymmetry, and so, okay, there is no flux for the asymmetry. However, we are expectation ready for this stage, the theta. And here R is the sphere. If you arrive at the equation that I had before, it looks like the following. And a similar equation correction on theta. So there's no asymmetry flux anymore, there's just standard covariant derivative. There are two equations, both are these equations, but these are the standard Killing spinor equations. And it turns out that each of these equations, which are the same equation, each of them has two solutions of the sphere. So we get two supercharges from here and two supercharges from here. So in this way, we can reserve actually four supercharges, which is the maximum number, because we started with four, so we can reserve more than four. In this particular case. Okay, what is the supersymmetry algebra? In this case, the supersymmetry algebra contains, well, first of all, we have this Lie derivative. And if I do the other tensor charges for a second, we will contain the asymmetry operator, the asymmetry charge. Yeah, it turns out that this combination is constant, but doesn't have to be real. It's not real, so this is not the complex quantity of this. Yeah. Yeah, of course it depends. Yeah, so of course it depends what coefficient you put for that you choose for attention here, is a dependent solution of this equation. But if you choose a real coefficient, these are real Killing vector fields, these vectors, and in fact what they do, they span the isometry of CO2 of S2. So here the point is the following, that what we go to here, in principle, also the metric is specified as all the other auxiliary. In general, we should discuss the complex metrics. However, this makes things very unclear, and someone would like to explain the real metric, and maybe not obvious that one can, but in fact, people can. So you get a real Killing vector field, and which is a big one because of the sphere. Okay, so this is the supersymmetry algebra of one gas, plus the condition on S1.